Hey guys, what's up and welcome back to a brand new What Even Is. I hope you liked my last episode of What Even Is, where I talked about the game called Celeste. Today we're gonna talk about a game that just hit Steam Early Access called Battalion 1944. Now even though the game is published by Square Enix, which we all know from the Just Cause trilogy, it is produced by a fairly new and unknown developer. Battalion 1944 is a game that really focuses on 5v5 first person action. It is set in 1944 during the Second World War. You have two different types of games, the ranked and unranked matches and the arcade matches. In arcade, you hop on a game that has randomized matches between the game modes Team Deathmatch, Capture the Flag, Domination and Free for All. Battalion recaptures the core classic of competitive shooters and refines classic FPS for the next generation. It focuses on 5v5 combat, where every shot and move counts. The game mode Wartime, which is used in the ranked and unranked matches, where all the competition is built on, you start with two teams, both have 5 players, and each player has a different role. You either have to defend an objective or destroy the objective. You play 13 rounds, and the one who wins most rounds is king. In this game, skill is king, no airstrikes or airdrops or dogs running through the battlefield. Battalion 1944 really wants to bring the old skill-based gameplay back, like in Call of Duty 2, for example. And boy does it deliver. Right off the bat, when I joined a rifle-only map, I got flashbacks to Call of Duty 2 where I would join a 24/7 rifle-only Tunisia server where nothing matters but skill. It really feels like an old-style FPS, but fixed so right that it fits with current generation expectations. The game lets you run your own dedicated server where you can tweak other settings to your liking, make it only rifle, or boost up the max player count to ridiculous amounts. And it works. The game is being produced by a company called Bulkhead Interactive, a company that has been around since 2013. It is a UK games development studio that was founded through the merger of two established studios, Deco Digital and Beevil Studios. The team previously worked together on Numa Breath of Life, which was the first game to ever be released on a console using the Unreal 4 engine. The two teams merged and became Bulkhead Interactive. The staff include lead designer David Jones, lead programmer Kevin Chandler, create lead Howard Philport and producer Joe Bremer. They have settled down in Derby, UK, and they are hiring if you're interested. When someone asked the developers about the game, they said something that really made me realize how long it's been since a good FPS game came out. I quote, "Battalion 1944 is being developed by competitive FPS players who grew up playing classic shooters and have worked to become one of the most experienced Unreal Engine 4 developers in the industry. As larger AAA developers are moving further and further away from old-school mechanics in favor of simplicity, we want to recapture what made classic FPS games feel so great. This means fluid, skilled gameplay with a fair and competitive battleground." End quote. The game got released on February 1st, a couple days ago in Early Access. They expect it to remain in Early Access for around 1 year. And they say they have a lot of plans and ideas they want to add in the game. Currently the game is around $50, and I'd say it's an extremely fair price. They did not expect this much attention to the game at release though, so the servers haven't been on point for the last few days. That is why it has a positivity rate of just 61%. But apart from the servers that are currently having some trouble, it is worth every penny. It sounds great, the models of the weapons and the buildings are amazing, and the controls are so fluid and they feel so swift. Playing it just makes me happy that there are still some producers out there trying to go back to what competitive gaming is all about. It warms my heart. I'm definitely going to keep supporting this game as I really want it to become something big. And I think it is really amazing that a developer that is popular like Square Enix made this game more popular around the globe. Alright guys, that's it for me already, but be sure to tune in tomorrow for another What Even Is. As always, if you like what you see, why not hit me with a like? If you want to see more awesome stuff from me, go and hit that subscribe button. Thank you. See you next time. Bye bye.